Hey, how's it going? Okay, so when you're working with your Python data and you want to export that to an Excel file, you'll oftentimes want to present your results in the form of a table. And when you're working with tables, you're usually working with borders, so let's learn about those. The first thing we want to do is to import the xlsx writer module. We want to create a workbook and a worksheet, and we're ready to go. Borders are a styling thing, so we're going to be working with format objects in the xlsx writer module. Let's create a full border format. So it's going to be a full border that goes around one of the cells in our Excel file. I access the border option and I give it the style of 1, and I'm going to give it a color, but I'm going to stick to the default black color for now. Great, so now we have a full border format that we can apply to one of the cells in our Excel file. We don't need any data for now. I just want to focus on the borders. Cool. So if I close this workbook now and open the Excel file, we should see cell B2, and it will have a continuous black border around it. So let's try that. Open my terminal, and you can see I've navigated to the output folder. That's where we need to be. We open that, and it looks like it worked. I'm going to zoom in a little bit just so you can see. See there? Cell B2 has a continuous black border around it, so it looks like we succeeded. Now, there's more specifications and configurations that you can make. Let's try changing the color of this border and only aligning it to the bottom part of cell D2. So you just want a border here along the bottom of cell D2. Close that down. We're gonna need another format object, and let's call that bottom red border. We're gonna replace border with bottom, and I'm gonna change the border styling to style 6 and give it the color of red. You may notice that I'm talking about styles here and not widths. It's actually not possible, as of making this video, to specify the width of your borders in the xlsx writer module. You have to use a table with various styles for your borders. I'm going to put a link in the description to the documentation, and it'll give you a nice list with some examples of the various types of borders that do have different border widths that you can make use of in your tables. But I'm talking about styles here and not border width, so I just want to underscore that. Cool, so we have our bottom red border format, and we want to apply this to a cell in our Excel file. Let's choose cell D2, and we're applying the bottom red border format. And I want to now just rerun all the code to make sure that we have this updated. Let's open our file once more, and there you have it. Again, I'm going to zoom in so you can see this in more detail. B2 remains the same. It still has its continuous black border all around the cell, but cell D2 now has a different type of border, and it's only applied to the bottom part of the cell. Notice also that it has a different color, so you can customize these borders and give them different colors and alignments. Notice that I named it bottom. If you're thinking, well, what about top, left, and right, you are correct. You can actually use the keywords top, you can use left, and you can use right to create borders on any side of a cell in your Excel file. Another question that you might have is, well, what if I have a table and I want one kind of border for the bottom part of my table and another kind of border for the top? It's a very good question, and it's actually possible to do. So let's create another format that's called, let's call it header border. And it will still have this bottom border of style 6, but we also want to add a top border to it. And we want that to be a different style. Let's keep the standard continuous line that we were using before. And let's use the same color. So we give it a red color. And as you might have guessed, you can use bottom as well, as we just did right here. So any part of the cell can be accessed. And if we now run this, we have a header border format that we can apply to another cell in our Excel file. So let's try that. Let's try that on cell F2. Header border. Just want to make sure that I close it. There we go. And let's rerun the entire code one more time. Cool. And open our Excel file once more through the terminal. And there you have it. So what we've done here, I'm going to zoom in again so you can see. What we've done here is we've created three different types of borders. In our first example, we had the continuous black border all around the cell. And then we tried creating just a border for the bottom of cell D2 and we gave it a color. And then we created this header border format that applies two different kinds of borders in the same cell, one for the top of the cell and one for the bottom. They both share a color, and we could feasibly change the color of this too, should we want to. But those are the basics of creating borders using the xlsx writer module. In future tutorials, we're going to expand this further and work on creating borders that go across several cells and several columns, but that is for a future tutorial. For now, just stick to the basics and try changing some colors, changing some borders. Enjoy.